إخوة الإيمان والإسلام, today I've come to you with a beautiful surah from the Quran al-Kareem to remind you and remind myself that Islam continues, Islam prevails within yourself, within the community, and within mankind altogether. If you're behind, then blame yourself. If you're up to date with Islam and you're practicing your duties, فَهَذَا فَضْلٌ مِنَ اللَّهِ. This is a bounty from Allah upon you. بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Briefly, let us taste the sweetness of the Quran, because we will never understand Quran, we will never taste its beauty until we reflect and pone down its verses. For every word in the Quran al-Kareem has a meaning behind it, has a reason behind it, hikmah, wisdom behind it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, والتين والزيتون, يقسم تعالى بالتين والزيتون. الزيتون والتين المعروفان. Allah swore by التين and الزيتون in Surah التين. And this surah was revealed to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم in Mecca. Why is Allah swearing by التين and الزيتون? Because they are very important and very beneficial. Allah does not swear by anything in the Quran al-Kareem except it is very vital for humans and very beneficial for them too. Be it the sun, be it the moon, be it the night, be it the day, or be it the teen and a zaytun. What is teen? The fruits, figs. These beneficial fruits that has so many vitamins. Ask the scientists, they will tell you how good this fruit is. You buy them dry figs. Why? Because it is expensive to buy them fresh. So they dry them so they last long, because the benefit they contain, only Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala in details. But they're very beneficial. And as zaytun, olives. Allah blessed the tree of olives. And we know how beneficial it is. Olives itself and the oil that comes from it. يُوْقَدُ مِن شَجَرَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ زَيْتُونَةٍ لَا شَرْقِيَةٍ وَلَا غَرْبِيَةٍ. Perhaps the second best verse of the Quran after Ayatul Kursi, the ayah of An-Nur. Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Ard. Allah mentions this tree of olives and he praises it and he says, Shajara Mubarak, a blessed tree. And what comes from olive oil and olives, the list of goodness and nutrition and vitamins, Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask the scientist. فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask the people of expertise if you do not know. So Allah swore by these two great creations of His. And then what else? ثُمَّ يُقْسِمْ مَرَّ أُخْرَى. And then he went on to take another oath. وَالتِّينِ وَالزَّيْتُونَ وَطُورِ سِينِينَ. And I swear by the mount of Tur in Sayna, which borders between Gaza and Palestine. Somewhere in Egypt, there where Musa alayhi salam spoke to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or let me correct myself, where Allah spoke to Musa. وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. Allah spoke to Musa directly and literally. There in Sayna, in the Mount of At-Tur, in Egypt. So Allah is swearing by this place, إخوة الإيمان والإسلام. And then he went on to swear the third time. وَهَذَا الْبَلَدِ الْأَمِينَ. And I also swear by this safe country, safe city, safe land. Which land is this? The land of Mecca, إخوة الإيمان والإسلام, حفظها الله تعالى. Allah swore by these three mighty creations to tell us what? To show us the importance of what? لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. To tell us that he created man in the best composition, in the best form, in the best shape. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ وَلِسَانًا وَشَفَتَيْنِ وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ. Didn't Allah create in us two eyes, two lips, a tongue? Didn't he give us guidance? Didn't he create us as beautifully as you see? لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم, in the best form. ولقد كرمنا بني آدم, and he favored you and honored you over all of his creations. He gave you العقل, he gave you البدن, he gave you إيمان, and he gave you all that which makes you the best of his creation if you obeyed him, if you followed his instructions. That's why Allah swore three times, لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم. And then the next verse says, ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين. And then we turned him back to the lowest of the low. After these blessings that Allah gave you, your eyes, your hands, your intellect, the guidance he gave you, the Islam he gave you, the messengers he sent you, all these ni'am, blessings he gave you, what did he do? He lowered you. He put you in the lowest part of what? Of status in this dunya. And in Jahannam, in the lowest part of Jahannam, وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. Why? Because all that he gave you, جَلَّ فِعُولَهِ, be it your eyes, your body limbs, the guidance he gave you, the Islam he gave you, the wealth, the family, you were not grateful to that. You used them not righteously. You used them to disobey him. You used them to cause corruption on earth. And that's why that turned against you and made you the lowest of the low. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِلَهِ. أَسْفَلْ سَافِلِينَ, the lowest you can have. In this life, in the sight of Allah, people might see you very famous, very respected in this life, but in Allah's sight, you're the lowest. And in Jahannam, you will be in the lowest part of the fire. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. Why? Because you were not grateful. You did not obey. You did not follow the Messenger عليه السلام وأجمعين. And then Allah went on to say, there is an exception in here. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ فَلَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ. غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ بمعنى غير مقطوع. متواصل هذا الأجر في الدنيا وفي الآخرة في الجنان. اللهم ارزقنا ذلك. آمين يا رب. Except those who believe and do righteous deeds. Because for them, there will be a reward that has no limit. That will not stop. The people who are grateful to Allah, they use their eyes in the way to please Allah, their hands in the way to please Allah. What Allah gave you, the blessings that Allah gave you, the wealth, the health, the mind, the family, leadership, authority, if you use it righteously, then you're not asfal safilin. You're not going to be from the lowest. You're going to be from those who will have unlimited reward in this life and in the hereafter. إخوة الإيمان والإسلام. جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار. فما يكذبك بعد بالدين. What can cause you to reject the day of a deen? What can cause you? What's the reason for you denying the judgment of Allah? The standing before Allah? The hisab of Allah? Nothing but ungratefulness, nothing but the whispers of the shaitan, nothing but your desires for this dunya. That what will deprive you from denying the standing before Allah for your account on the day of resurrection. أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين. Is it not that Allah, the best judge of all judges, the best ruler of all rulers, the wisest جل في علاه? Of course he is. البراء بن عازب رضي الله عنه وارضاه, he said, I had the messenger of Allah in one journey. They were traveling, reading this surah, surah teen. فما رأيت أحدا أحسن صوتا ولا قراءة من رسول الله. I never had anyone better voice, with a better voice or better reading than the messenger of Allah. And in this verse, Abu Huraira also reports to us the last verse of surah At-Teen, أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين. Is it not that Allah, the best of all judges, جل في علاه? He says, when you hear this, say, فقل بلى وأنا على ذلك من الشاهدين. Of course, oh my Lord, and I am a witness for that. This surah is very important, إخوة الإيمان والإسلام. If you want to be from those people who Allah gave them a special exception, إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فلهم أجر غير ممنون. Except those who believe in the Tawheed of Allah, وعملوا الصالحات, they follow the Sunnah of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and the good deeds in general. فلهم أجر غير ممنون. They will have a reward that has no limit. If you want this, if you want this, إخوة الإيمان والإسلام, then Allah is not to be worshipped in Ramadan only. Then Allah is not to be worshipped in the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah only. But Allah is to be worshipped by every servant of His until Malak al-Maut comes to you. If you want this reward continuing, فَاعْبُدَ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ As Allah says in the Quran, worship your Lord until the only certain thing in life comes to you. And that is nothing but al-Maut, death, ikhwat al-Imani wal-Islam. Let us do our best to continue worshipping Allah with the best we can. Let us do our best to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask Him to accept our good deeds and forgive our bad deeds. Let us do our best, ikhwat al-imani wa islam, to revive the sunnah of our Rasul sallam and go back to the Quran of Allah, for it gives us the spirit of Islam, the sweetness of Islam. Try your best to read the meaning of the Quran. A surah like this is a short surah, yet what's behind it? Treasure of knowledge, ikhwat al-iman wa islam. So do not deprive yourself from the knowledge of the Quran and its sweetness and its beauty.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فلهم أجر غير ممنون فما يكذبك بعد بالدين أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين.